వెల్కమ్ టు కౌటిల్య సైన్స్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ. సైన్స్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ రిలేటెడ్ జీకే అండ్ కరెంట్ అఫైర్స్ ఇయర్ టెక్నాలజీ రిలేటెడ్ సైన్స్ వి డిస్కస్. ఇట్ మీన్స్ స్పేస్ టెక్నాలజీ, న్యూక్లియర్ టెక్నాలజీ, మిసైల్ టెక్నాలజీ, డిఫెన్స్ రిలేటెడ్ టెక్నికల్ డిఫెన్స్ రిలేటెడ్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్, కంప్యూటర్స్ ఆర్ కంప్యూటర్ రిలేటెడ్ టెక్నాలజీ, దీస్ ఆర్ మెయిన్ టాపిక్స్. వెన్ ఎవర్ వీఆర్ రైటింగ్ ఎనీ కంప్యూటర్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్, సమ్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్ రిలేటెడ్ టు సైన్స్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ వీ మస్ట్ కాన్సన్ట్రేట్. సో ఫస్ట్ వీ గో టు అవర్ స్పేస్ టెక్నాలజీ, ఇండియన్ స్పేస్ టెక్నాలజీ. యాక్చువల్లీ అవర్ స్పేస్ సైన్స్ ఆర్ స్పేస్ టెక్నాలజీ, ఆఫ్టర్ యూరి గగారిన్ వెంట్ టు స్పేస్ దెన్ ఇట్ వాజ్ స్టార్టెడ్. యాక్చువల్లీ ఫస్ట్ ఇన్ 1957 సోవియట్ యూనియన్ సెంట్ టు స్పేస్ నిక్ 1. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ వన్ డాగ్ ఆల్సో వెంట్ టు స్పేస్, దట్ ఈస్ లైకా ఇన్ 1957. దెన్ 1961 ఫస్ట్ ఆస్ట్రోనాట్ ఆర్ కాస్మోనాట్ యూరి గగారిన్ వెంట్ టు స్పేస్. దెన్ వీ స్టార్టెడ్ అవర్ స్పేస్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఇన్ 1962. ఇండియన్ స్పేస్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ వాజ్ స్టార్టెడ్ అట్ ద టైమ్ ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా జవహర్లాల్ నెహ్రూ. ఈ స్టార్టెడ్ ద స్పేస్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్. చైర్మన్ వాజ్ అపాయింటెడ్ టు ది స్పేస్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్. దట్ పర్సన్ ఇస్ విక్రమ్ సారాభాయ్. యాక్చువల్లీ విక్రమ్ సారాభాయ్ బేసికల్లీ న్యూక్లియర్ సైంటిస్ట్. దిస్ పర్సన్ వాజ్ అపాయింటెడ్ టు చైర్మన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ఇండియన్ స్పేస్ డెవలప్మెంట్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఆర్ స్పేస్ డెవలప్మెంట్ కమిషన్. ఫస్ట్ టైమ్ వాజ్ స్టార్టెడ్ దట్స్ వై విక్రమ్ సారాభాయ్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఫాదర్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియన్ స్పేస్ సైన్స్. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్ ఇన్ 1963 our government started, it means Tumba Rocket Launching Center or Tumba Equatorial Rocket Launching Center in Tumba village, Tumba. Tumba Nethiravananthapuram, Kerala. It is now calling VSSC, Vikram Sarabhai Space Center. India's first rocket launching center is Vikram Sarabhai Space Center. After the death of Vikram Sarabhai, then that name is dedicated to, the person name dedicated to this rocket launching center. It is the first rocket launching center in India, that is Vikram Sarabhai Space Center. After some years, same year in 1963, first woman went to space in the world, that person is Valentina Tereshkova. In 1969, the most important event was occurred in the world. Human being first time landed on moon. Neil Armstrong, Edwin Aldrin, these people landed on moon from USA. At the time, we started our space development purpose. ISRO started in Bangalore. That's why Bangalore is also called as now Space City of India. Research and development purpose, ISRO, we started in 1969. Indian Space Research Organization. Its headquarters located in Bangalore. So Bangalore is called as Space City of India. Present its chairman is K. Shivan, Tamil Nadu person, K. Shivan. Previously, Dr. S. Kiran Kumar was there, but present is Shivan. from 1969 onwards we started development of our infrastructure. Between this period, whatever facilities are required for the infrastructure development of space technology, then we established between this period. Same time in 1972, Space Commission was established. Space Commission and Space Department was started. Space Commission, Space Department was started in 1972. And between this 1969 and 75 period, we developed our infrastructure facilities. We established infrastructure facilities. Suppose, for example, you take satellite launching center, launching. That means satellite launching station is Satish Dhawan Space Center. Basically, it was called Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota. Basically, it was called as Sriharikota Hal to Train Shore. Satish Dhawan Space Center was established. It is the first and present only one satellite launching center. Basically, it was called as SHAR, Sriharikota High Altitude Range. Whenever Satish Dhawan was died in 2002, then its name changed from SHAR to Satish Dhawan Space Center. Second launching station will be established in future in Nagayalanka. It is only just sanctioned, it is not constructed so far. Second will be established in Nagayalanka in Krishna district in Andhra Pradesh. Island area, in this place government is planning to establish, Space Department planning to establish second launching. In Sriharikota, two launching pads are there. Third launching pad is also constructing. With the expenditure of 1500 crores, it is constructing. Whenever third launching pad is completed in our country, at the time up to 4000 kgs satellites also we can launch from our country. Present we are launching 3000, up to 3000 kgs also. More than 3000 kgs satellites are there. We are launching from French Guiana. It means Kourou Space Station. Heavy satellites we are launching from Kourou Space Station, French Guiana. Normal mini or micro nano, these satellites are launching from okay India. Generally satellites are different types are there. Nano satellite means below 10 kgs. Below 10 kgs satellites are called as nano. Micro satellite means micro. Between 10-100 kgs, that is called as micro. Any satellite weight is between this weight, that is micro. After that, mini satellite 100 to 100 above, 1 to 500, it is mini satellite. It's medium, 500 above to 501 to 2500. Heavy satellites above 2500 satellites are called generally five types of according to weight categories, or these are categories. And we are controlling satellites are controlling from controlling center, controlling from two places, MCFC, Hasan, Karnataka, MCFC, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Second one is Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Two places we are maintaining control centers. MCFC means Master Control Facility Center. MCFC, Master Control Facility Center. It is two places we are controlling our satellites. Hassan, Karnataka, 20 kilometers from Bangalore. This is their district headquarter. From here we are controlling. And Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Next, another one is Picture Receiving Center, Satellite Picture Receiving. Picture Receiving from NRSC, Shadnagar. National Remote Sensing Center, National Remote Sensing Center, it is located in Shadnagar. And Space Application Center, Application Center is located in Ahmedabad. These are the main whatever required, those facilities we arranged up to 1975. And fuel is also manufacturing in Tanuku, Andhra Pradesh. Liquid oxygen and liquid hydrogen, that is fuel, satellite fuel, is manufactured in Tanuku in West Godavari district, Andhra Pradesh. And satellites, according to nature of work, satellites are two types in our country or anywhere. Generally two types. One is communication satellites like GSAT, INSAT. These are communication satellites in our country, communication satellites. Known as remote sensing satellites. Remote sensing IRS series, previously CartoSat series, MetSat series, ResourceSat series, RISSAT series, all these are remote sensing satellites. Two types of satellites: communication satellite, GSAT or INSAT, remote sensing satellite, IRS or MetSat, and also meteorological satellites. All these are remote sensing satellites. Our country's first satellite of our country is Aryabhatta. India's first satellite name is Aryabhatta in 1975. We launched it from Baikonur Cosmodrome from Soviet Union. At the time, Soviet Union, present it is located in Ukraine. Our country's first satellite of our country is Aryabhatta. On April 19, 1975, it was launched. After that, India's first remote sensing satellite, that is Bhaskara 1. It was launched from Baikonur Cosmodrome in 1979. Remote sensing Aryabhatta general satellite was launched in 1975. After 4 years, it was launched from Baikonur. 79. First satellite was launched from Indian land is that is Rohini from Sriharikota in 1980 through SLV-3. It was Rohini was launched. And first communication satellite is is apple. Our country's first American satellite is Apple. Apple means Ariane Passenger Payload Experiment. It was launched from Kourou Space Station. French Guiana, this Apple Ariane Passenger Payload Experiment. Because French Guiana launching satellite through Ariane launching vehicle. Launched in this satellite was launched in 1981. Apple full form is Ariane Passenger Payload Experiment. After that, INSAT series started in our country. INSAT was started in 1982. After that, IRS series was started in 1988. Like this type of series was started. Next, we have to concentrate about launching vehicles. Satellite cannot go to space its own technology. Compulsory, it is taken by one satellite launching vehicle. Some countries are calling rockets. We are calling satellite launching vehicles. Our first generation launching vehicle is SLV. Suppose for example you take Rohini. It was launched from Baikonur Cosmos, Srikota through SLV launching vehicle. It is now outdated. First starting very early we used SLV. Second generation launching vehicle is ASLV. Augmented Satellite Launching Vehicle. It is also outdated. Augmented Satellite Launching Vehicle. These two are outdated now. Present working condition, satellite launching vehicles are PSLV and fourth generation launching vehicles are GSLV. These two present we are using in India. PSLV, Polar Satellite Launching Vehicle, GSLV, Geosynchronous Satellite Launching Vehicle, not Geostationary, Geosynchronous. Very advanced satellite launching vehicle is GSLV. The most successful launching vehicle is PSLV. So many satellites, more than 95% success rate is there, just only two were failed. Only two were failed so far. For starting very early, PSLV D1, after that recently PSLV C39, PSLV C other than these two, remaining all satellites are very successful. That's why the most successful launching vehicle in India is PSLV. The most advanced launching vehicle is GSLV. We are using XL engine. Last 18-20 times we use PSLV XL engine. But GSLV point of view, we are using cryogenic engines. Cryogenic engines. If engine works very low temperature, it is called cryogenic engine. Russia is very famous in the world to make these cryogenic engines. India is manufacturing our own cryogenic engines. Very advanced satellite launching vehicle, but failure rate is somewhat more compared to PSLV. PSLV success rate is very high, but GSLV success rate is very low. That's why we have to know some information about PSLV, GSLV. PSLV more success, but GSLV less success. That's why we have to know about some PSLV and GSLV. Continuation, go to PSLV. This PSLV series started in 1993. Then onwards we have been launching these satellites. Latest what we launched, we have to know. Latest PSLV C40. Latest PSLV vehicle, that is PSLV C40, on January 12th 2018 it was launched. Through this launching vehicle, total 31 satellites total 31 satellites were launched. 3 Indian satellites plus 28 foreign satellites, totally 31 satellites. The main satellite of our country is Cartosat. Cartography, the study of maps is called cartography. Cartosat F2F, Cartosat 2F, and also Microsat, very small satellite, Micro. And INS, Indian National Satellite, these are also very small satellites, 1C. The 3 Indian satellites, remaining 28 foreign satellites, we launched on January 12th through PSLV C40. Before PSLV C40, PSLV C39, it was failed last year, August. Month of August 31st, 2017, this PSLV 39 was failed. Actually, this one navigation satellite IRNSS, one H was launched, one H was launched. But previous 7 navigation satellites were success in our country, but this 8th one and overall PSS-39 was failed. Whenever this launching vehicle was failed, then the satellite also waste. IRNSS, Indian Regional Navigational Satellite System, Indian Regional Navigational Satellite System, it was launched on August 31st, 2017, but it was failed. But in PSLV history, it is the second satellite only, the second launching vehicle. First PSLV D1, after that PS39. Total year 39, there 3, total for 42, out of 42 vehicles, only 2 were failed, remaining 40 are success. Nearly only just 96-97% per success rate is there, that is PSLV. That's why you remember 39 was launched in the month of August. IRNSS 1H. Actually, IRNSS series first ordered 2-3 years ago. Total 7, 1A2, 1G completed, those are working. For navigation system developing point of view, Indian Regional Navigation System Development point of IRNSS series, first 7 completed, but 8th was failed. It was failed. After that, PSLV C38. You know, we take 38, PSLV C38. It was launched in June 23, 2017. Through this PSL 38, Cartosat 2E plus 30 foreign satellites were launched, 30 foreign satellites and Cartosat 2E. These Excel engine used, general Excel engines are using, that is also remember Cartosat 2E. Very important, last year February, same exactly this month, C37, through 37, India created world record because maximum number of satellites was launched through one launching vehicle. Total 104 satellites were launched. 104 satellites were launched through PSLV C37. 3 Indian plus 101 foreign satellites, 3 Indian satellites, Cartosat 2D and INS satellites also. Cartosat 2D and INS 1A 1B. These two are small nano satellites, and totally three Indian satellites, 101 foreign satellite. In this 101, only one country satellites are 96 from USA. 96 satellites from USA. Remaining different Kazakhstan, Israel, and also like this Switzerland, Netherlands, UAE, these country, five countries satellite, totally 101 satellites. USA 96 satellites were launched through PSLV C-37. And in 2016 December, C-36 was launched, but last 1 year back, that much of not useful. It is resource sat. December 2016, December 7th actually. It is resource sat 2A. Resources proposed 1235 kgs. This satellite was launched through PSLV 36. And this every year we are launching so many PSLV launching vehicles. The reason is success rate is more in PSLV, but JSLV success rate is less. That's why we are launching more PSLV launching vehicles. Next you go to GSLV. It is the most advanced satellite launching vehicle series. It was started 2001, but in 2010 years some launching vehicles were collapsed. That's why the point of view we are not using more GSLV satellite. GSAT and also INSAT satellite, generally heavyweight satellites are launched through GSLV. We are using cryogenic engines also, cryogenic engines. GSLV we have concentrate here, GSAT also we concentrate. GSAT 9. GSAT 9 was launched on 5th May 2017. It is South Asian satellite. South Asian countries purpose on satellite we launched in our country. South Asian satellite was launched, that is South Asian purposes also, not only India and our neighboring countries, Nepal, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, these countries purpose it was launched in the month of May through actually GSLV Mark 2. kgs. Ready one, we first defense intelligence satellite also we launched GSAT 7 2013. This is our country's first defense intelligence satellite. GSAT 17. 28th June 2017. GSAT 17. This launched from Kourou Space Center. 3447 kgs. This heavyweight satellite was launched through Ariane. This Kourou Space Center. So Ariane launching vehicle, Ariane 5 ECA VA-238, that was 3447 kgs. JSLV D not GSAT. GSAT 18 in 2016 it was launched October 5th. It is also through Ariane series 231, VA 231, 3404 cages, that is GSAT 18. And GSAT 9 also, sorry, 19, GSAT 19. 5th June 2017. Through GSLV, first time India launched 3000 above cages satellites. GSAT 18 was launched from India from Sierra Kota. Through GSAT 956 2017, 3136 cages. Very heavy satellite launches so far from India. And GSAT 20 is planning in ISRO, is through actually Mark 3 D2. That is GSAT 20. These are main, you remember PSLV and GSLV launching vehicles and also some satellites whatever launched. Present India is planning to launch RLVs, reusable launching vehicles. Already we tested reusable launching vehicles. Whenever these are made in our country, these are uses at the time, definitely huge money is possible to save, because present satellites are just fusion through satellites. Whenever RLV comes, number of times we can use. And through PSLV, actually in C25, whenever you take PSLV, C25 is also very important in this PSLV series. The reason is PSLV C25, there is Mangalayaan project is completed. Mangalayaan November 2013, this PSLV C25 Mangalayaan project was completed. We reached to Mars Orbiter through Mars Orbiter mission. MOM means Mars Orbiter mission. It was conducted also PSLV G and C25 and through PSLV C8. Sorry, C11, PSLV C11, Chandrayaan, one was launched, but it is partially success in 2008. After that, government is concentrating PSLV. Okay, remember PSLV, this was C25 from MOM. It is reached to Mars Orbiter. Chandrayaan was launched in 2008 through PSLV C11 actually. But in future, Chandrayaan 2 is planning in future either 2019 or 20 through GSLV XL vehicle. India is Chandrayaan point of view 6th country in the world. Any human being did not launch or did not go to moon. Okay, Rakesh Sharma and also Sunita Williams and these people, Kalpana Chawla, went to space only, but they did not enter, they did not landed on moon so far. Whenever everything is success, then 2019 or 20, India is planning to launch one Land Rover on moon. Whenever it is success, Chandrayaan 2 is returned, then Chandrayaan 3, through Chandrayaan 3 we are planning to send human being, that is also remember. But Chandrayaan point of India is 6th country in the world. Mangalayaan point of view in the fourth country, in first country in Asia, because China did not conduct this Mangalayaan project. Chandrayaan point of view, India 6th position, Mangalayaan point of 4th position. Top 6 countries in Chandrayaan project point of view, America, Russia, China, and also France is there, and ESA, European Space Agency. But Mangalayaan point of only 3 countries, America, Russia and ESA, European Space Agency. Other than these countries, next India is conducted only Mangalayaan project. These are the main points to remember about space technology.